ओम तत्सत् नमस्ते एंड गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल। कम ऑन, लेट अस लिसन टू वन मोर स्टोरी, स्टोरी बाय ग्रैंडपा। सर्विस टू पेरेंट्स, सर्विस टू मदर एंड फादर। Our ancestors have said that we are indebted to five groups, five persons. We are indebted to our parents who bring us up during our infirm age, the childhood when we cannot do anything on our own. We are indebted to the society which creates so many facilities, comforts for us to lead a comfortable life. We are indebted to the nature which works for us, for our convenience, for our living, creating food, oxygen, potable water, and everything else that we need for a comfortable and good life. We are indebted to the rishis who have showed a path to nobler life, better life, better communal social life, so that there is peace, there is harmony. The rishis have guided us through various texts and various stories and various festivals, even proverbs, to guide us in our life. And finally, we are indebted to the God that we could take birth as a human, we could take birth with all abilities, with intelligence, we could take birth in a civilized and cultured family. We have not put in any effort to choose our family background, choose our place of birth, the country of birth. It has just happened to us. So we are indebted to the God. So these are the five factors, five groups to whom as a human we are indebted. And the aim in life is to try and pay back all the debts to all the five of them. Service to parents, that is the primary duty of any child, son. The daughter serves her parents before marriage and then serves her in-laws and husband. The son has to carry on service of parents till their last breath. That is the message handed down to us by our ancestors. Now here is a story which was retold by King Dasharatha, father of Sri Rama, when he was immersed in the misery, gloom of separation from his son. He had given a boon to his wife Kaikeyi, who was dear to him. And Kaikeyi asked for those boons at a very crucial moment of coronation of his eldest son Sri Ram. She wanted her own son Bharata to be coronated as king and Sri Ram to be banished into the forests for 14 years. And Dasharatha was in a helpless state. He had to accept to Kaikeyi's demands. And when Sri Ram came to know about this, he went away. Dasharatha was so engrossed, so immersed in this misery of his separation of his son from him, that he almost was at the last moment of, final moment of his life. Now he remembers this incident and said, "My death is nearing me. This incident happened long, long back and I was cursed by the old man, the blind old man, to death, grieving separation of my son." So he recounted this incident as though in a flashback. That time was long, long before this Rama's exile. That was the time when Sri Dasharatha had no son, and he prayed for a son. He was desperately wanted to beget a son so that the lineage could continue. There was a misgloom, pain in his heart that he didn't get a son. Now in those days he went into the forests for a hunt. The kings were allowed hunting. Hunting was an effort to retain their bravery, to retain their skills, warfare skills, and also to retain the sharp edges of the weapons. Now he was in the forests, gone for a hunt. When he heard the sound of an animal drinking water from a water source, crook, 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 it, to Dasharatha, it seemed like an animal drinking its water. Dasharatha had a skill, a unique skill of Shabda Bhedi Bana. He could follow the sound and direct his arrow towards the source of sound without seeing the object. He did not see that object through his eyes. He could just act on the basis of sound. That was a special skill of Dasharatha. So he sent his arrow in the direction of the sound. And in a few seconds, there was a yell, there was a human throat yelling, "Hey!" So he understood, he thought his own mistake, a grave mistake. So he walked towards the, ran towards this spot and found a small boy, a teenage boy. He was in a pool of blood, struck by an arrow at the, on the banks of a source of water, lake. There was a pot by his side. The boy said, my parents, old parents, infirm and blind, they are seated near under the huge banyan tree towards the northwest of this direction, southwest of this direction. So kindly take this pot of water to them and convey the message that their son is dead, has been killed. So Dasharatha went with pot of water. He didn't make any sound. He walked without his sandals and approached to them without sound and gave them water to drink. The father asked, Shravana, what happened? You were not talking? Then Dasharatha says, it is not Shravana, his son, but it is Dasharatha, the king of Ayodhya. The old man, he asked him, what's the reason that Shravana has not come and sent the king? The king Dasharatha says, it was a grave mistake by me. I thought an animal is drinking water and I shot my arrow and your son is dead. Oh, the parents were shocked. They fell unconscious. Then after a few moments, he rose up. He said, oh my son Shravana, his life, he did nothing else but serve to us. In this small age of boyhood and childhood, he was not like any other child of his age. He never sought anything for himself. And he served. His only life was serving us. And we were born blind. So he tried every means to fulfill our necessities. Even during the death moment, Dasharatha said, he saw me with the bow and the arrow and he knew I was the one who struck the bow. Struck the arrow on him. Yet he didn't get annoyed, he didn't get angry. He remembered his own parents. He asked me to take this pot of water to you. That was greatness of your son. The parents again fell unconscious. They rose up again. By this time the mother was dead. The father said, what is the use of my living? I have no purpose to live. My son, he came to know that I wanted to go on pilgrimage, but being blind, we could not go. So he made a balance like he tied two cane baskets on both sides of a bamboo, a pole. He carried the bamboo on his shoulders and carried both of us seated in these baskets. He would take us to holy rivers, make us take bath or make us dip in the holy rivers. He would visit holy shrines, describe the shrine to us. Oh, his life was only, the only mission was service to parents. And now we have lost him. I see no purpose for my own living. So I'll quit this world. But I curse you, Dasharatha, that you too will die due to separation from your son, dear son. That was the curse given by this old man, blind man. Dasaratha returned home to Ayodhya. Instead of becoming sad and unhappy over the curse, he celebrated the curse. He lighted lamps all over the palace and celebrated the curse. When asked by his charioteer, the chariot driver, he says, "I have no son, but his curse, if it has to come true, I am sure to get a son." That's the happy message from this curse. So it's a matter of celebration, says Dasharatha. That was the greatness of this Bala Shravana, a young boy Shravana, guiding us and asking us to be in service of our parents. We offer our humble pranams to such great souls, Bala Shravana. That's all for the day. I conclude this story. We'll meet again with one more story tomorrow. Om Tat Sat.